Praise God, saints. Little Bible study. Bread slice. God is good. I'm excited. Praise God. God is teaching. God is blessing. God is making way out of no way. Praise the Lord. Praise God. Praise God. All right, what we're going to talk about tonight, what we're going to talk about, we're in the scripture of Genesis 39, starting in verse 6. We're talking about Potiphar's wife. Talking about Joseph. Joseph was a blessed man. And it's really, really like a type of shadow of Christ too. Hey, glory to God. Really like a type of shadow of Christ. Joseph was second in charge, was slave. So it's really like a type of shadow. You can see, you got to think about the Old Testament. Types and shadows. Praise God. But he won't get right into it. Not going to be long. Praise God. We're going to be blessed. Amen. Anyway. So anyway, it's just, okay, Genesis 39, starting verse 6. Now, I'm going to summarize. I'm going to read some scriptures. I'm going to summarize. We'll get into it. Praise God. So, again, like I said, Joseph was a blessed man. And saints, you got to realize, when you bless, that enemy's going to come after you. Why? Because he's after the anointing and the blessings. He's after the anointing and he's after the blessing. That's what he's after. See, Joseph blessed. Okay, so let's go into this. So Potiphar left all that he, and I'm reading this in Amplified version. Praise God. So Potiphar left all that he owned in Joseph's charge. And with Joseph there, he did need to pay attention. He did not need to pay attention to anything except the food. Praise God. Now, it says this in verse 6. It says, Joseph was a handsome, attractive dude. He probably got these big old arms and rippling abs and big old triceps. So he was swole and he had it going on. He was a good looking dude. Like I said, sort of like me. I mean, look at these guns. Look at them guns. Boy, they're coming at you right through the screen. So here we go. Now, Potiphar's wife. See, Potiphar was a captain of Pharaoh's army. He was the captain of the guard. So he had the best. So Potiphar's wife, you know she had to be fine. She had to be fine. Egyptian woman, Potiphar's wife. Over the captains, he was a captain over the guard. So, she had the best. So, she was fine. She was fine. Now, scriptures don't give her name. So I'm going to call her Diamond. So Diamond, Potiphar's wife, that's the name I gave to her. All right. Okay. So Diamond, the scripture said this. Now, Diamond, like I said, Joseph was a fine dude. Diamond was lusting. The scripture said this. He said, and what is that, boo? Hey, do-do-do-do. It says, but he, go back. It says, and it came to pass after these things that his master's wife cast her eyes upon Joseph and she said, lie with me. Come on, brother. You know you want to be with me. Come on, let's just, I know you want me. Joseph said, not having it. Because see, scripture said this. Now, I'm going to jump to verse 9. Because Joseph's mind was set that, this sin is against God. But I believe this, saints. I believe Potiphar's wife, Diamond, tried all kind of stuff. I bet she had it all set up. I bet she was like,
I think about the day I met.
Come on, Joseph.
The perfect stranger.
Come on, Joseph.
I think about us.
Joseph was like, you ain't thinking about us because I ain't thinking about you. So get on about your business. But that ain't going to stop somebody lusting. It's not going to stop that devil. That devil. See, people fail to realize. They get the victory one time, then they want to quit. No. No. That enemy don't stop. Because is it verse here, verse 8, it says this. Verse 10 says, and it came to pass as they spake to Joseph day by day that he hearkened not unto her to lie by her or to be with her. That devil didn't stop. Diamond didn't stop. She was after him. I bet you Diamond had it all set up. I bet she had the music. I bet she had the LED lights going. I bet she had the bar set up, the music. I bet she was on him. Telling him, make it last. I bet she was all in his ear. Joseph, let's make it last. Joseph, come on now. Come on now. Joseph, I ain't love. What do you mean, don't let I love in? I had nothing. I don't love you. I love God, not you. But part of her wife didn't stop. Now, that was verse 10. She was like, she was on him day and night. See, that's the same way with your blessings. That devil's coming after your blessings, coming after your anointing day and night. He ain't going to stop. He ain't going to stop. So there, here we go. And check this out, saints. Now, this is some crazy stuff. It's a crazy stuff. See, this is why Matthew 26:41 said, you got to watch as well as pray. You got to be watching because that devil was constantly trying to set you up. Constantly. So now here, verse 11, summarize it. Joseph goes to work. He ain't thinking about Diamond. That's Potiphar's wife. That's my name for him. Now, I don't want to write to this music. Now, I don't know if Potiphar's wife had this music or not. I don't know. But that devil was so crafty. So now, anyway, so Joseph coming to work. He ain't paying it no mind. He working. Because why? His heart is unto God. And many of us, this is the way it is, but you got to watch as well as pray. Matthew 26:41. You got to be watching because the devil is busy. So now he goes to work. Diamond sent everybody home. Ain't nobody in the kitchen. Nobody doing nothing. Everybody at home. You just sent everybody home. It's a day off. Okay, now, here Joseph come to work. Now, look at this devil here. Look at this devil here. Waiting for him. Waiting, just waiting for him. Joseph in the house working. All of a sudden, here we go. So we're like, oh, what the hell is going on here? Listen, I imagine Papa while doing this. Never seen a sunshine like this. Joe said, Never seen the moon glow like this. No. Never seen the waterfalls like this. No, Diamond. Never seen the lights off like this. No. Never dug anyone like this. Listen. Never had tasted lips to kiss. Tasty lips, sister. I ain't tasting your tasty lips. And this ain't happening. So what happened? She grabs him. Joseph bails. So saints, what is the moral? What is the revelation? At times you got to run. When that devil grab you, talking about them tasty lips, you better get the hell out of Dodge. That devil mean you no good. What is he after? The blessings. He's after them tasty lips. That's what he said. He's after the blessings. Don't let him get them tasty lips. Run. That's what you got to do. So Joseph left. Yeah, she called the guards after that, you know. Yeah, they took him to prison. But even in prison, he was still blessed. Why? Because the anointing doesn't stop. It doesn't stop. So some of you going through some stuff, wondering why? Because the enemy's after your anointing and your blessing. But it doesn't stop. You will increase if you stay committed to God. Be blessed.